Hello friends, I am Rashika Rawat.
I am Yashraj Purohit.
Today we are here with Mr. Param Shah sir.
Hi Rashika and hi Yashraj. It's good to have you here and hi all of you from SKIPS. Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce is one of the oldest and the largest chamber of commerce of this country. It is the apex organization established in the year 1927 at the say of Mahatma Gandhi, where he asked business community to consolidate together to fight against the Britishers, and we are fortunate to have him at the 4th AGM of FICCI as well. As a apex body and the Chamber of Commerce, we are the industry's voice for policy change. We work extensively on around 72 sectors of the economy for policy changes, and we are the bridge between the government and the industry.
Sir, as you know that this time the budget is coming a bit earlier. So, sir, our viewers would like to know the views regarding the coming budget. So, sir, my first question is that what are our expectations regarding the budget from our finance minister?
See, as far as the estimations and expectations from budgets are concerned, they are based on the advanced financial estimates that we make and the GDP figures that are there. And this time, the advanced figures show that the estimated GDP growth at 11.9%, which is higher than the budget estimate of last financial year at 11%, which means, and of course taking into consideration the demonetization as well, there is a huge financial scope for the finance minister to give sops and also give benefits passed on to the citizens of this country, and hence the expectations are very much high. As far as the tax rates and the tax slabs are concerned, for personal income tax, we would want that there is some rationalization in the exemption limit and the tax rates and the slabs which are currently applicable, which would also help the economy on overall terms as well.
Sir, can you comment on the GST effect on the middle class and upper class people?
See, as far as GST is concerned, it is simplification of taxes. It is not complicating the tax, which is the first myth that is there. Of course, it will have any change that comes in, it will have an impact on the economy. As far as people are concerned, consumers are concerned, there is not much of a change that you look at, because what they are doing is doing away with multiple taxes and consolidating it at one single tax. Hence, in terms of your costings, in terms of consumption, will not go up or come down drastically. Hence, as a consumer, there would not be much of a change. But again, all this, given that the rate of taxes or the slabs that would be decided, would be rational. If they are pegged at a higher rate, obviously it will cost us dearly as consumers. If it is pegged at a lower rate, obviously it will be a benefit as well. So we need to wait for the rates of the taxes to be declared post-budget, and by July 1st when it is being implemented, we will have all of it and clarity will be there, and hence more comments could be given by then.
Sir, there are also some major changes to be expected in the housing sector. So, sir, can you throw some light on this?
See, as far as the housing sector is concerned and affordable housing is concerned, it is a main mandate of this particular government, which has come in force since 2014. And the Prime Minister has also announced some major SOPs and benefits on New Year's Eve, on 31st December 2016. So we expect a lot of more changes to come in the housing sector and the affordable housing bracket particularly. We as FICCI have asked the government in our pre-budget memorandum to raise the interest slab, which is exempted for income tax purposes, from 2 lakhs to 3 lakhs, which gives a more benefit to the person who is availing of the housing loan. Also, we've asked in some changes in the calculation of the exemption for acquisition of new houses. Currently, only after the handover of the house from the builder to the consumer is when the calculations start. We ask for a few changes in those as well. So overall, we do see a positive change coming, because the target of the government of having a house for all or a roof for all by 2022 will only be achieved by drastic changes coming in the affordable housing area.
Thank you for your prescribed time, sir, and valuable views.
Thank you so much. I look forward to having you again. Thank you.
Thank you.